Hey, what does it do, my hoes and homos? I am genuinely excited to be here and to be presenting this information to you all. I've got a little bit of information that I was actually going to save for a larger video, but considering the events that have transpired, I think I'm going to choose not to hold out on it. And me and my buddy Zero Needs Coffee have decided that it's probably just best to put this information out there because the situation just keeps getting worse and worse and worse. You know, Jalen did a racism. Not once, not twice, but three times.
Fuck you, nigger.
Never said nigger in my life.
Yeah, that's not funny.
And you know, it was just gonna be a segment, a part of an upcoming video. We weren't really gonna go after it all too much. But then Jalen drops this absolute gem of a video, the problems with Stonetoss. And in the thumbnail, it says, racist? Question mark? And that really piqued my interest because of the events that have been taking place. Cause I thought Jalen was such a fan of edgy humor and racist jokes, it would seem. I wanna be perfectly clear. I do wholeheartedly believe that you can make a racist joke and it can be funny, but Jalen is really bad at being funny. So what do you get when you remove the joke from the racist joke? Not to mention, context is extremely important. Like, the first quote-unquote joke was okay, the second one was questionable, but the third one was just in really poor taste. So I went and watched this video about this supposed racist Stonetoss individual, and let me tell you what, some of his comics are in poor taste. That's not what I'm here to talk about, though. I'm here to talk about the absolute hypocrisy that is conveyed through this video. She really went and posted this like a few days prior. She wasn't metaphorically kneeling on black men over Discord. Listen, I messaged Jalen about this and I understand where she's coming from. Like, these comics are trying to push a racist agenda or whatever, which I personally don't believe, seeing as it's not working on me, but I do understand how it could create a circle jerk of people that do believe racist things. Like, yeah, they're gonna enjoy this kind of stuff, but I don't think that it was made specifically for them. And even if this is making so many people racist and it's pushing some hidden message, that's not the point. The point is that you have no room to speak on this topic. Absolutely none. Especially if you want to keep on making edgy jokes in the same vein that you're making. You can't do this and go and moral grandstand Stonetoss comics for making a racist joke. I'm sorry, but you have to pick a side. This isn't like being bisexual where you can play both sides of the spectrum. And also, I'm not here to moral grandstand Jalen at all. I've made just about every edgy joke there is. Every fucked up statement that I possibly could have said, I've said it. But I've only ever said these things to people that would understand that I was joking in those contexts. And I've never said these things to people that would be harmed by it, or publicly. And I know that you're lying if you say that you haven't said some fucked up shit. It's not the edginess of these jokes that's the issue here, with me at least. It's the fact that it's extremely hypocritical, and I know that it did affect my friend. Like, go ahead and say all the fucked up shit you want. Literally, joke about anything. But just know that if you do it in the wrong context, you're gonna have to be prepared to apologize. And I know that Jadyn isn't gonna do that, because she's told me in DMs that she thinks that Zero is a snake and a scummy guy. She doesn't see this as herself being in the wrong at all, because that one time that she said the N-word to him, she was under the belief that he wasn't recording, which he wasn't. His other friend who was in the voice chat was recording, and Jalen had only asked him if he was recording. So Jalen thinks this is all justified because of that, because she forgot to ask the other guy if he was recording. Like, yeah, you're obviously not gonna say this shit if somebody's recording, but that's the point. If you want to catch people doing scummy things, you have to do it without them knowing. I mean, that's how John Swan got caught. Do you think he would have exposed that detail if Nicholas DiOrio was like, oh yeah, I'm recording this for the record, by the way, just so you know. If you haven't picked up from the previous mentions of this screenshot, let me explain it to you. Zero sent Jalen one of his videos that was about her, and she replied with this image of Salvo Pancakes with, on his screen, he's got a picture of Nicholas DiOrio kneeling on flamenco, but it's the picture of George Floyd getting kneeled on, nonetheless. Jalen said, me kneeling on your dead channel, to which Zero responded with, lol, we'll see who's dead in a bit, Lamau. I'm literally gonna destroy you. Wait till word about this gets out. Bit extreme, yes, I'm aware, but imagine you're black and you piss somebody off a little bit and they just respond with a George Floyd joke. Honestly, how did you expect him to react? And in case she didn't know, he said, I'm black. And Jalen said, okay, And it's like, yeah, you're black and I just made a George Floyd joke to you, but that's not an issue. Like, I'm not entirely sure how fucking retarded you have to be to get the logic that this is just you being edgy. I would say it's fine and edgy if you're just making this to your white friends, but once you make this comment to a guy that doesn't particularly like you out of malice in the fact that he is black, it goes from just being edgy to being able to justify it as being racist. You're a channel with 270,000 subscribers. You can't just go around and do shit like this and expect people not to care. But now you're probably wondering, oh, well, how is she such a hypocrite then? Well, let's take a look at a few clips from her Stonetoss is racist video.
This Stonetoss guy is not a very good guy.
I'm gonna find where you work, and I'm gonna get you fired from your job, and then you're gonna wind up homeless, and then you're just gonna fucking die on the streets. Fuck you, nigger.
If you're gonna say that this guy is a bad person just based on what he says, then you probably fit in that same category as well, and therefore probably shouldn't be talking on topics like this. Like, how do you even know that this guy is a bad guy? You've never met him. You've probably never actually interacted with him. You're literally basing his entire character off of a stupid comic that he made online. Not to mention, if somebody said that you were a bad person, you would probably just respond with, it was an edgy joke. Because that's basically what's been happening with you and Zero.
And a lot of people in the commentary community have just defended him blindly because they like edgy humor. And I like edgy humor too. But this guy is not just making edgy jokes.
So let me get this straight. This right here is racist. Undeniably, irrefutably racist. If you support this, if you laugh at this, you are a racist.
How can you ignore gun violence in America? A shooter just massacred a dozen people. He was black, and so they ignore it. I think the messaging is pretty clear in that one.
However, this is just an edgy joke.
No, I've never said nigger in my life. Fuck you, nigger.
You know, maybe they're both actually edgy jokes. Maybe they're both actually racist. Who gives a fuck? The point is that you're being a hypocrite for trying to convey that you are not a racist when you say shit like this, and this guy is a racist for insinuating that the media does not care about black people committing mass shootings.
And then we got this one, which is just pushing like an anti-Semitic conspiracy theory. It's a hard knock life.
Wait until somebody tells Jalen that, Judaism is a religion. And I know these ones aren't jokes because you are very, very open about hating religion, and you like to remind us about every week on Twitter that God is dead. So don't even try to hide behind this one as a joke. You realize that anti-Semitism is literally fucking based on hating religion. Like, I'm aware that you have an issue with Christianity, but labeling it as religion does include Judaism. Point being, if you're gonna criticize somebody for being anti-Semitic, you should at least look at your Twitter history. Even if you might not be anti-Semitic, but you're very open about hating religion, which is the exact same thing, just more broad.
Seems pretty clear to me that this guy has some very messed up views. And if I were you, I wouldn't be supporting this guy.
Let me be clear, I think it's very, very okay to criticize this man, but if you're gonna say that people shouldn't support him because of his views, then you should be also willing to say that people shouldn't support you because of yours. You do see the hypocrisy in this, right? He views his comics as jokes. You view your statements as jokes, but yet people aren't allowed to support him because of his jokes. It's all really just perception, and it's down to whatever the majority thinks is right. So if you really do think that you're in the right, go ahead and respond to Zero's video, because you should be able to prove it wrong, and if you are in the right, then obviously all of your viewers will agree with you. Either way, you fucked up once, nobody really cared. You fucked up a second time, a few people cared. You did it a third time, and it became an issue, and then you go and moral grandstand somebody who does the exact same thing. That's the point where it starts to become a little bit scummy. Also, I do have to point out that while I was making this video, Jalen did contact me and offer to apologize to Zero. Her exact wording was, I mean, I can apologize to Zero if that makes things right. And I basically said something along the lines of, yeah, you should apologize, but that should have been because you knew you were in the wrong, not because you think this is going to start negatively affecting you. To which she said, I didn't even do anything wrong though. And then we got her in a call and she told us to kill ourselves at the end of it. And called us more slurs, not the N-word, though. So that was fun. Either way, guys, this isn't some cancel Jalen or go shit on Jalen. It's more of don't do this kind of stuff, all right? It's kind of shitty. Edgy jokes are great. Come on, they're pretty funny a lot of the time. But if you're not funny with them, they just come off as, you know, mean, for lack of better words. And anybody can argue that edgy jokes are mean, but I'm pretty sure you can tell when they're actually not funny. Like, if this is comedy, this is some Amy Schumer level shit. Make edgy jokes. And you know what? I don't even care if it's not funny. Make edgy jokes, but just know the limit. It's pretty fucking obvious where the line is. I'm pretty sure we can all agree on that. Either way, guys, if you enjoyed this video, for some godforsaken reason, considering leaving any form of engagement on it, whether it be a like, a subscribe, or even a channel membership. Jesus fucking Christ, I'm so sick of shilling. If you like listening to my voice, just it would mean a lot if you could find a way to support me. That's what I'm saying. There's a lot of links in the description. So, you know what? Until next time, fellas, goodbye.
I'm pretty stupid, all right?